evening, one day after the I-Team reported the findings of an audit into the Jefferson Performing Arts Society, there's a new area of concern this evening, at least one from one council member.
This is a story that we first reported to you Monday on WDSU News at 6 o'clock. The chairman of the Jefferson Parish Council now has concerns regarding the compensation that's being given to the executive director of the Arts Society, while his group was asking for additional public money.
WDSU investigative reporter Travis Mackle is live in the studio with us with details on these new developments. Travis?
Norman, a closer look at the salary of the executive director has one council member asking a lot of questions. This comes on the heels of a scathing audit into the Art Society, alleging a lack of checks and balances, money mismanagement, and even it raises the possibility of fraud. After reviewing an internal audit of the Jefferson Performing Arts Society, Council Chairman Chris Roberts came out swinging.
The initial findings indicate to us that their record keeping is very much off base.
The audit, first reported by the WDSU I-Team on Monday, details findings of money mismanagement. The Art Society operates with a budget of about $2 million a year. Documents reviewed by the I-Team show that about 30% of the money comes from public coffers at state and local governments. Records show that last year the Art Society asked for and received extra emergency money from the parish, more than $300,000, and that's why Councilman Roberts has a problem.
That raises red flags.
In large part because of what the JPAS is paying its executive director. Dennis Asaf, by all accounts, is an accomplished artist and is heavily involved in the group's popular productions, and he's been rewarded for his efforts. Public records show Asaf made almost $170,000 in total compensation last year. That's similar to what Asaf made the prior year. But records show in 2009, Asaf made $144,000, meaning he received a pay raise of almost $25,000 the following year.
When you give raises, substantial raises, which apparently has occurred within the last 2 years, of an individual making close to $170,000 a year, it's very concerning when you're sitting here poor-mouthing that your organization is in financial trouble, but you find out that people within the agency are getting raises to the tune of $30,000.
And records confirm Asaf is no stranger to pay raises. Public documents filed with the federal government show that in 1997, Asaf made $83,000. In 2001, his salary was almost the exact same, but it jumped as high as $132,000 in the next 2 years, before dropping back to its earlier range when Hurricane Katrina stormed ashore. From there, the increase has been significant. That Katrina cut? In 2006, Asaf made about $86,000, but in 2007, he received an almost $40,000 pay raise, earning $136,000. And subsequent increases brought Asaf's paycheck to its most recent level of almost $170,000.
Maybe that money that was spent on a raise would have been better off hiring an internal accountant and bookkeeper.
Federal nonprofit records show that a salary of $170,000 puts Asaf in the top tier of all similar nonprofit directors nationally. Locally, he far exceeds the median for an arts-based nonprofit director and a nonprofit with a comparable budget. Records show most of those in the top 25% of nonprofit leaders in our area make much less than Asaf.
It becomes very concerning for me and my colleagues, because how can you come to us with a straight face and say that your agency is in financial trouble and needs a hand up in order to stay afloat, and then accept a raise to this magnitude? That's the problem.
Parish records show that a salary of $170,000 is more than any parish employee, including Parish President John Young and anyone else on his staff. We contacted the president of Asaf's board to ask about his salary. Those calls were not returned. We're interested in how the number is set, as the director of the community theater group is paid more than not only his nonprofit peers, but Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal, New Orleans Mayor Mitch Landrieu, and the Chief Justice of the State Supreme Court, Burnett Johnson. The salary matter is not the focus of the audit, but has become a concern in part because of the report and a previous separate audit note a shortage of staff positions inside the organization. The Jefferson Performing Arts Society has until next week to respond, and its comments may be included in the final version of the audit. Asaf told us on Sunday that some findings in the report are off base, but did not elaborate. Parish President John Young has temporarily halted funding to JPAS based on this audit. Norman?
All right, Travers, we should also note that while Dennis Asaf may be among the higher compensated nonprofit executives in town, he is also among the most tenured. Asaf helped found the JPAS in 1979. He recently received the Distinguished Merit Award from the American Association of Community Theater.